Okay, I'm gonna go to the slides and I'm gonna share the slides with you. So empirical, great. Okay, are you guys looking at the empirical rule with me?
Yeah.
Okay, this is very good, I did it. I got it, okay, great. So empirical rule, there are three numbers to it, 68, 95, 99.7. So all it says, 68 represents 68%. So that's an area or maybe a probability. 95, it means a probability as well, 95%. 99.7 is also a probability. So what those three numbers mean is about 68% of the observations are gonna be within one standard deviation. So you have a diagram, you have a bell curve to show you as well. So right here is a zero. One standard deviation, that's gonna be z score for one minus one. So between those two, I'm gonna draw two virtual lines here. The area in the middle, that's gonna be about 68%, as you can see here. 95 means about 95% of observations are gonna be between minus two and the positive two, right? Okay, so 99.7, this is fairly close to 100%. That means almost all of the observations are gonna be between minus three and positive three. Okay, so if I were to ask you, if you do see an observation with a corresponding z-score of a plus five, so that means a z-score plus five, that's gonna be somewhere here. How likely it is? Is it likely? It's very unlikely because this empirical rule actually says most of observation is gonna be somewhere in between plus minus three. You have a five, that's gonna be so far to the right, it's very unlikely. And as you can see, as you go to the right or maybe go to the left, the tails actually die down. So there's a very, very small probability. For example, here, anything beyond a three standard deviation, that's a 0.15%, that corresponds to 0.0015. Very, very unlikely. Right, okay. So this is actually what empirical rule says. You were like, when am I gonna use the empirical rule? You can only use empirical rule if you know it follows this bell curve. That means equivalently it's saying you have to know the distribution follows a normal distribution. If it doesn't follow this normal distribution, it doesn't follow this bell curve, you cannot use empirical rule. Okay. And you were like, you know, we have already learned about a z-table. Why do we learn about the empirical rule? Well, empirical rule is only an approximation of the z-table. The reason I say that is because empirical rule has only very few numbers, as you can see. It only talks about plus minus one, plus minus two, and plus minus three. It doesn't help you to solve the problem if you were dealing with 1.94. It wouldn't help. If you are dealing with minus 2.70, it wouldn't help either because they are only dealing with a whole numbers, plus minus one, plus minus two and three, right? Okay, so empirical rule is only approximation, but at the same time, it's gonna make ourselves, our lives easier because all you need to do is you're gonna remember those three numbers. You don't have to look up the Z table anymore. You just have to remember the those three numbers. For example, if I were to ask you, I know a person's height follow a bell curve, what is the likelihood? What is the probability? Anyone is gonna be between plus minus two standard deviation away from the mean. You were like, you know, I learned the empirical rule. I know it's gonna be the second number for two standard deviation. That's about 95%. You can tell me right away. And if I were to ask you, what is the probability of a person's height? More than two standard deviation, more than two. You were like, more than two, how do I know it? Okay, you're gonna use this bell curve, look carefully. So between plus minus two, that's a 95%. Okay, so you know that is a plus minus 2%. So what is the corner here? Okay, so I'm gonna just draw it here. Okay, so you know it is a plus minus two here. What is the likelihood of more than 2%? Okay, what you can do is you're gonna use 100 minus 95%. That's gonna give you 5%. You're gonna over two. The reason you divide by two is because this corner should have the same area as this corner due to the symmetry of this bell curve. So I'm going to use a 5% over 2, and that's going to give you 2.5%, right? 2.5%. Okay, so 2.5%, you can see here as well, is a 2.35%. You're like, this is not right. We are supposed to get 2.5%. And the reason is because, it's a 2.35% here. There's also a 0.15%. If you add up those two numbers, they are gonna give you 2.5%. Do you guys see it? 2.5%. Okay. So the probability of someone's height more than 2 standard deviation above the average, that's going to be 2.5%. If I were to ask you what is the probability of someone's height more than 3 standard deviation, you can use this diagram right away. That's going to be 0.15%. You don't have to look up your table anymore, right? This is going to be much easier. Okay, so what I want to emphasize here is make sure you guys have those numbers on your note card, those three numbers, and also those small numbers given here. You want to copy those numbers on your note card as well, right? Okay, so let's work on this problem, and that's gonna be the last exercise we're gonna work on. So what they were talking about here is, they were talking about gasoline price. Regular price per gallon is about $3.44. I'm sure the gas price has dropped quite a bit nowadays. And the standard deviation 0.01. And we also know that the retail price has a bell-shaped distribution. So this part is very, very important. And we know that it follows a bell curve, so we can use a normal distribution. Without having a normal distribution, we cannot use the empirical rule. And this question specifically asks you to use the empirical rule. You guys see it here. Okay. So the very first thing you need to do is you want to write down all the information you were given. Okay, X represents the gas price, it follows a normal. That's the average and that's the standard deviation, right? Okay, so what you wanna do is you want to figure out the percentage of a regular price. So when you see a percentage, this is a hint for you. You were asked to find probability or maybe area. So what percentage of a regular price, gas price, between 3.24 and 3.64, right? Okay, so the first thing you need to do is you wanna think about it, 3.24, what is the z-score for 3.24? What's the z-score for 3.24? So 3.24 is less than the mean, which is 3.44. It's actually 20 cents less than the average. And you know that a standard deviation is 10 cents, so this is actually 20 cents less than the average. So that means it's a 2 standard deviation less than the average. And so you should know the z-score is gonna be minus 2, right? Is this part clear?
Can you show it on the table maybe? Or like, how does that work? Why is it minus 2?
Yes, I can definitely do it. Yes, okay, so let's see. Good question. So let's see. So 3.24, I want to come, so the observation is 3.24. And what we also know is the mean is 3.44. And the standard deviation is 0.10. So what we wanna do here is, what is the z-score, right? Z-score. So the formula goes this way. It's gonna be observation minus the mean. Hopefully you guys remember, right? Okay, so I'm gonna plug in a bunch of numbers. So the observation is 3.24, as you can see here, minus the mean. Okay, and divided by standard deviation. So that's, the numerator is gonna be less, minus 20% over 10%, oh sorry, 10 cents, that's gonna be minus 2. So is this part clear how I did it?
Yes.
Okay, so this is how I did it. The z-score is minus 2. No problem, not at all. Okay, so the next one we want to do is we want to talk about 3.64 as well. So this is actually, if you look carefully, this is 20 cents above the average. And the standard deviation is 10 cents. So 20 over 10, that's another 2. But this time, it's going to be positive 2, right? I'm going to show the answer. So that's going to be positive 2. You guys see it? Okay, so what we want to do is we want to find the area between positive and also negative 2. Okay, so you can look up your table. You can do it twice. We have already talked about this. The first time you look for the probability for 2. The second time you're gonna look for the probability for minus 2. And then you're gonna use the bigger probability minus the smaller part. And you can do it that way. Alternatively, you don't have to do any calculation because this is a plus minus 2 standard deviation. You were like, I learned about empirical rule. I know this. This should be 95, right? You remember it. The second number for empirical rule, remember empirical rule has three numbers, 68% for plus minus 1, 95% for plus minus 2, and 99.7%, which is almost 100%. That's for plus minus 3. And so we are talking about plus minus 2. That's going to be 95. Is this part clear how I did it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Great, great. Okay. So let's go on to the next one, the next question. And
I had a quick question.
Yes.
So for exams, would you prefer we write it as the decimal 0.95 or 95%?
Good question. So typically in an exam, because we are doing these exams online as well, the question is going to be very clear. If it gives you a percentage sign next to it, you probably want to put 95. Okay. If it doesn't, you want to use the decimals.
Perfect. Right? Thank you.
You want to use the decimal. Typically, you want to use the decimals. But if the question has a percentage sign, you want to use the 95%. Okay. I think I only asked you guys to use the decimal. But a single-digit assignment, sometimes they have a percentage sign. You want to change it to 95%. But single-digit assignments are very specific as well. It's going to tell you round it to 4 decimals, 2 decimals. Same goes for my exams, all the quizzes as well. I try to be as specific as possible. Okay. But if you do have any confusion, feel free to email me and we can sort it out. Great. So the next one we have here is, so this is a fairly similar. Again, it's between 2 numbers. So 3.14. Okay. So 3.14, the mean is 3.44. What is the average? What is the z-score for 3.14 then? 3.14 compared to 3.44, that's 30 cents less. And you know 10 cents is one standard deviation. This is 30 cents. So that means it's going to be minus 3. You guys see it? Minus 3.
Yes.
Okay, great. Okay, I'm going to clear some of that writing. Okay, good. So similarly, you can figure out for 3.54 as well. So this is actually just 10 cents above it. Okay, great. I'm going to move the question so we are all on the same page. Okay, so that's going to be, you should be able to calculate that one. That's one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so yeah, is everyone able to see it?
Yes.
Good. Okay, so next we want to do is, again, it's between plus, minus 3 and 1. So again, you can use the table to find, but you were asked to use the empirical rule, so you probably don't want to do that. So what you want to do is you want to use the bell curve to figure out. So we are looking for the area between minus 3 and 1. So this is not exactly plus minus 2 or maybe plus minus 3. This is between minus 3 and 1, minus 3 and 1. So I'm going to show you how this can be done easily using the bell curve, using the empirical rule. So it's very essential. I'm going to share the screen. Hopefully I can do it once. Great. I think you guys have it. Okay. So remember, we are doing minus 3 and 1, right? Minus 3 and 1. Okay. So minus 3 is right here and positive 1 is here. So we are looking for the probability in between of those. Okay. So what you want to do is first is you want to draw a vertical line here, also a vertical line here. We are finding anything in between. So that means there's anything here, right? You guys see? Okay, so what you need to do is actually pretty straightforward. If you do have this bell curve on your note card, maybe on the side when you work on the exam, on the assignments. So all you need to do is you're gonna add up this number that represents the probability between minus 3 and minus 2. You're gonna add up this probability, 13.5%, between minus 2 and minus 1. And also 34%, which is minus 1, 0, and also this one. You're gonna add up those 4 numbers. Just this 4, not this one. But this one, okay. This one, this, and that. Because this is gonna give you exactly the total area between minus 3 and 1. So you're gonna add up those 4 numbers. Okay, is this part clear?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. Great. Okay, so let's see how I work it out. I can show you in a Word document. Okay, so let's see. I have to add up four numbers, as you probably remember. Okay, so this is exactly what I did. I add up four numbers. Wait a second. Well, you see, I made a mistake. I was wrong. This shouldn't be there. It should start from 2.35, so this is wrong. So it should be 2.35, 30.5, 34, 34. So those four numbers. You should add up those numbers, and so I think this number is also wrong. But you, I'm sure you guys can add up those numbers without, right? Okay. So the very last one, you know, I'm just, you know, going over a little bit over time. What percentage of regulars sold for less than 3.64? So the first thing is, you notice this is observation, and you want to convert it to z-score. So this is a 2. And so what percentage of them is less than 2? So you should be able to easily read it from your diagram as well. So minus 2. So I'm looking for 2, to the left of 2. Okay, so let's see. I'm gonna do a last screen sharing with you guys. Okay, great. So I'm looking for, is it positive 2? I think it's positive 2. So we are looking for to the left of positive 2. So I'm looking for a positive 2 and to the left of positive 2. So it's gonna be here. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna add up all those small numbers here, but you don't have to do that. Alternatively, you can use 100% minus this one and that one. That's gonna give you the same numbers, right? Don't you think so? So instead of adding up all those numbers to the left of 2, I can use 100% minus those 2 numbers to the right of 2, right? And so this will, you know, will help you to solve this exercise, and so you can see I've already solved it here as well. Yes. Right, so the numbers are revealed to you. 97.5%.